9 singles away from Azul, but there's no one here, so let's save it for the end. Anyway, so where did we leave off? We left off when Noble Bell College was about to get introduced somewhere like Chapter 7, right? Lecture Hall. And let's begin Chapter 7, Better Acquainted. I've been expecting you. Oh man, I don't know how to get what type of voice to give him. Esteemed guest from Night Raven College, welcome to Noble Bell College. Let me know about the voice options I'll do. I'll be swapping them around a bit. Judging by your uniform, you must be a student, the head mage mentioned. That's right. My name is Rollo Flame. I serve as the student council president here. Oh, interesting. Our school doesn't have an independent student council, but it sounds like you all do. Indeed. And while it may sound presumptuous, one could call it the face of our school. Please, to make your acquaintance.
I immediately encounter with strangers!
Isn't the whole... Isn't the whole point of this social to meet strangers?
The human named Rollo, there's something about his presence.
He's not smiling at all. Is he angry about something? This is our vice president, and this is our aide. When they heard they could meet such an esteemed group, they dropped everything and came running. The entirety of Noble Bell College welcomes you. Our school is small compared to yours, and you may find it lacking in some way, but we beg your indulgence. How courteous. You have impeccable manner for someone so young. Guess he just has a resting deadpan face, but he's actually nice.
Yeah, I'm glad we weren't doing anything to offend them.
We couldn't allow you to keep hauling your luggage around, so of course let me show you to your rooms. I'm afraid it's a bit of a walk. We can use it as an opportunity to get better acquainted, though.
Here we go with the guy who always wants to break the ice before getting to the main event. You can't expect me to shut up a total stranger.
Why is he even here?
Not the most promising. Give me a sec. Wait.
That was an actual yawn. Not the most promising starts. Chapter 7, Better Acquainted. Okay, wait a minute.
Ah!
I clicked the same one. Sorry about that.
Chapter 8. So,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We got more. 8. We got 9 in total. Let's see if we get our usual viewers here by then. Okay. So much better. I don't have anything to hydrate, but I should be fine for just an 8 chapter stream. After this, I'll also be doing the schedule. I need to check when the thingy's going to update. Why does this shit? Oh, right. I press the add button. There we go. Anyway. As for the schedule next week, I may... It's a little bit wonky, but it will be at least two Twisted Wonderland streams again. One on Sunday, and the other one's probably Wednesday.
As for a third stream, I do not know. I want to do more V-Stream streams, so who knows? It'll probably be there.
Chapter 8, such talented mages. Asajur Jr. Imagine, it's quite the honor being student council president, considering there can only be one in the whole school. I'm sure your academic performance is also superb, and will guarantee you a promising future. Noble Bell College simply has a smaller student body.
I can hardly
compare to...
Hey, you!
Sorry about that. Noble Bell College simply has a smaller student body. I can hardly compare to those of you from the Night Raven College. God damn it. I was mixing the name. I was gonna say Great Raven College. Please, you needn't be so humble or formal.
What?
You're technically my upperclassman. Everyone at my school would be overjoyed to acquaint themselves with such a fine individual. Alright, as you wish. I won't stand on ceremony so much. He's laying it on so thick! Excuse me, Azul. What, can't you see I'm busy? Dude, why are you cozying up extreme style? It's making me nervous, I know. Whatever you're definitely means you're up to no good. Despite his modesty, he occupies a position of equal to us house wardens. There's no question he's an exceptional mage. Hence, it only makes sense to build a rapport with him while we can. For the sake of future interest. I've been observing Ash and Grotto for a while. Is that how one expands their social circle? Perhaps I should take a leaf from his book. The damage is spreading! But where are my manners? I've gotten ahead of myself. Apologies for the belated introduction. Introduction won't be necessary. I already know who all of you are. Razul Ashengrotto, House Warden of Octavanil and a Merman from the Coral Sea. My, where do you get that information? And you're iddia Shroud, House Warden of Ignihite and affiliated somehow with the Shroud family.
How do you know?
And you! You are Malleus Draconia, scion of the ruling fate of Imbriar Valley, and one of the top five mages in the world, correct? Indeed I am, Malleus Draconia. Of course the great Malleus would be known even in such a tiny burg. You're a Sebek Siegbold, and you hail from the same land as Malleus, and the one next to you is Silver.
Oh my god!
Why are you pulling out the scarf, goddammit? The utter hate on Rollo's face when he said you. I didn't even notice it. I'm noticing this now, though. And over there...
One sec. Man, why am I yawning so much? Hey.
And over there, chatting with our vice president, is Riddle Rosehart, House Warden of Hartschlabule. Rick Hunt, Vice House Warden of Pomefiore, Jamil Viper, Vice House Warden of Scarabia, Ruchi Bucci, Deuce Spade, and Ipo Belmere. I thoroughly pursued the documents Mr. Crowley so kindly sent, you see. It's like privacy's a foreign concept to that man.
That can get you stood in this day and age.
A very good memory.
Recall so many different faces. It's simply because I was so eager to meet such talented mages. But who have we here? You two there. Might I ask your name?
Wow, I'm the Great Grim, future Great Mage. Wow.
I'm new. How do you do? You please don't. That's such a dad joke. You must be the student attendants Mr. Crowley mentioned. He said you couldn't use magic. I certainly wasn't expecting you to bring a familiar.
A familiar? What are you talking about, me? It's the other way around. I'm the boss and use my henchhuman.
What a dependable companion you have. Ah, that face. He was very arrogant. You, I must imagine it must be taxing living among mages all the time. I entreat you to forget about school while you're here and enjoy a moment of respite and philosophy. And I hope the rest of you will enjoy the social. I'm truly grateful for your hospitality.
Think nothing of it. But look here.
This is our front square. It's something of a symbol for our school. Is this where the... Yep, there's the statue.
You're so sus.
Irene, he's so sus.
He showed you, hey!
Yay, people are starting to come in. Hope you're doing well. I am doing horribly. I spent like the first 10 minutes of the stream being really depressed about my mod. I hope you're doing better though.
It's an altogether different feel.
Azul's talking. It's an altogether different feel from Night Riven College. Yes, there's certainly a dignity about it. Makes me feel like I should straighten up or something. Look, there isn't a single fallen leaf on the flock. Don't they keep this place... They keep this space spotless. When I hear it was such a small school, I fear it may not be fitting for my liege. But this seems quite suitable indeed. Ay, mierda. I need to wake up, damn it. The students of our school are firm proponents of cleanliness. They're fastidious about maintaining a pristine environment. No dirt, no grime, and no backwater dirty non-human species. Yes, this place does possess a certain immaculate beauty. I see you appreciate it. Noble Bell's core tenets are purity and integrity. For my part, I prefer places that are a bit older and decrepit, one people tend to avoid.
Those are called ruins.
What kind of school would it be if people avoided it anyway? Well, be that as it may. How does it strike the rest of you?
It's amazing. It really drives home that we're in a totally different school. I never visited another arcane academy before.
Yeah, same. I'm kind of nervous about it, to be honest.
But it's also got some similarities to Night Raven College. Like, we have a statue on Main Street.
Yeah, wow.
There's one that reminds me of the statue of that one scary lady. Wow.
You mean the Queen of Hearts statue, the one you and Ace burned?
I totally forgot about that. Wow.
So they got only one statue, huh? That guy in the heart looked like he'd yell at me if I sneezed wrong. I think it was a king of her, but he's not really dressed like royalty. In fact, I wager he wasn't all that rich.
So who's the statue based off of? Wow.
This is the righteous judge. Righteous, right. That's One way to put it. He was so very righteous. Oh yes, oh dear. Very righteous.
The righteous judge?
Oh, so you're not familiar? He was a great individual. All the history books say so. The freshmen might not know, but I do cover him in sophomore history of magic.
Of course I remember the lessons, Professor. I would never forget your teachings.
I don't know, maybe my class hasn't gone to him yet?
A remedial lesson it is, then. The righteous judge is a prominent figure in Floor City's history. He was known to be highly impartial and always delivered appropriate verdicts. He's a notable historical figure on par with the Great Seven themselves. Precisely. The story goes that his fair judgment brought peace to the city when scoundrels threw it into turmoil.
Wow, what a cool legend!
Everyone in Floor City holds him in the highest esteem. The students of Noble Bell College likewise seek to emulate his honorable conduct of pervertness and corruption.
Ah! What was that?
Was that a bell?
Sorry, hiccups.
It was rather loud. Yes, that was the Bell of Solace.
Talk about a grandiose name.
Fuck! Set the peanut gut in my throat. God damn it, let me try again.
Talk about a grandiose name.
Was most deserved. The bell is an incredibly unique and valuable magical artifact that's been part of our school for generations. You all must treasure it. Is it comparable to the dark mirror at Night Raven College?
Yes.
Arcane Academies possess magical artifact that become emblematic of their school. It's been many years since I've heard of the Bell of Solace myself. Oh, have you been here before? Decades ago, yes, I came here on my honeymoon. I never actually got to see the bell. It's very rare and valuable, you understand, but my wife was quite taken with its beautiful tones. Would you like to see it now?
May we truly?
Certainly, the whole purpose of this social is to gain a better understanding of one another. I hope you appreciate how lucky you are. You will not get many occasions to view another school's magical artifact in person.
A real bell, huh? I bet it's all shiny and made of pure gold.
Oh, magnifique, what an object of beauty. It must be, I can hardly contain my excitement. The tall edifice there is the bell tower. You'll find the bell on the top floor.
Okay, Bell of Solace!
Why is it some thinky rat shack? Why is the bell in a thinky shack?
What's the matter? You've both gone strangely quiet.
How many floors is the bell tower?
Why don't they have an elevator? The place is a tiny of an upgrade!
Are you guys okay? You're covered in sweat.
Say, what if you took a broom? Surely they have some brooms you could borrow.
Shit. What a cruel suggestion. Flying would just take them longer and exhaust them even more.
I know, be sure, I know. So this is all it takes to reduce you to a miserable heap, Azul?
Yes, you clearly need a more rigorous training regimen. You should follow Malleus' example.
Apologies for the climb. It's a very old building, so the only way up is on foot. I should try and give him a French accent. I mean, this is based off Franz in Hunchback of Notre Dame.
A school takes just as much pride in this building as the bell itself. I do hope you'll take in all the scenery here. It's rather vast and complex, actually. They say the person could even live here.
Yeah, like the Hunchback.
But hurry not, we're almost at the top.
Yeah, Jamil's just enjoying Azul's suffering. He's such a sadist. Oh my god, it's such a classical bell feel. It's not even overly done.
Made it! I made it!
So, this is the top floor.
Is that it there? No.
Yes, we hold. The Bell of Solace.
What a big bell. Now that's a gorgeous bell.
Impressive. We have a bell that tolls to tell the time in Prior Valley. I never seen one so large. I wonder if this bell would be able to arouse even you, Silver.
I can only hope so.
Look at the way the sunbeam highlights this brilliant gold luster.
Is it actually made of pure gold? Damn!
You know it was, you'd never be able to carry it back. It's magnificent. I'm so very glad I was able to view it in person. This will be a fine tale to tell my wife when we are reunited.
Yeah, that's true. Sorry. Got distracted there for a second.
I'm pleased to see how you take and you all are with...
Sorry, I tried to give it a French accent and I just butchered that sentence.
I'm pleased to see how taken you all are with it. But its true dawn lies not in its beauty.
It is pure gold, Bishoujo. Just look at it. Just look at it. It's all yellowy and shiny. It has to be gold.
I'm pleased to see how well you are taken with it, but its true draw lies not in its beauty. Remember when I said the Bell of Solace is a magical artifact? Well, not only is the bell infused with magic, but so is it sound.
But it does sound like a Romanian vampire accent!
The ringing of the bell carries magic throughout the city, safeguarding our people. It's said that long ago, this very bell saved the city from a horrific disaster.
Thus its name.
The sound of a bell saved an entire city. It's just an unfathomable magical might dwells within Night Raven College's dark mirror. So too does the Bell of Solace. Ring contains a powerful magic.
It's gold, Bishoujo! It's gold! Don't ruin the fantasy!
You'll find a great many rare magical plants growing here in Velocity, which is another gift of the Bell. It sounds suffuses the city with magic and spurs magical plant to grow rapidly. We have gorgeous magical flora that would wilt anywhere else,
You won't find scenery like ours anywhere. Elsewhere, I bear and flower are constant sources of resources to the people here. How splendid! I can hardly wait to lay eyes on your floral city myself. We have designated a ringer sound bell in the morning, at noon, and at night. What you just heard was the noon bell. Its solemn tolling wakes the city up, stirs its heart, then announces it when it's time to rest. Magnifique! Fascinant! Fascinating! So the local structure that lives according to the peals of the bell. What a beautiful organization! And look up. And look up beyond the bell. What a view.
We are now. Whoa! I didn't realize just how up high we were. Well, now that I'm looking, I'm getting a little dizzy. Quick, someone push the cat! Push him down the building!
Well, we did climb a lot of stairs. The people below look like ants from up here. Was a sweeping view, only but one word springs to mind. Beauty! Is that sparkling body of water leading out the city a river? Yes, Nobel College sits in the center of a huge river. It's called Soleil, and it actually joins to a much larger river elsewhere. The school is connected to the city by four bridges that cross the Soleil. We pride ourselves on this view as well. So the Soleil runs through the middle of the city, and Nobel College stands in the middle of the river. Looks like an eye shape. Kinda does, like one of those Egyptian eye shapes. Correct, across the river, you can see the busiest road in Floor City. Oh wait. Correct. Across the river, across the river, you can see the busiest roads in Floor City.
Wow, I can't believe how high we are. I lean over the railing and look down, and it feels like I'm flying.
Ah! What's wrong, Silver? Why didn't you start like that? You get drowsy again.
No, look over there to the side, Sebek. Oh, it's...
Okay, all right, we're already near the end, damn.
Oh, holy shit, we're over an hour into the stream, damn.
Sorry about the drop rate, but it should not be that bad, right?
I must apologize.
It's not actually a gargoyle, is it?
It's a grotesque.
No, look over there to the side, Sebek. Oh, it's a gargoyle.
Bit rates? Stop that. You stop that right now. And get good. Get good again. Can you guys see and hear me properly? Okay, I think it's going back up again. That's good, that's good. At least not too many drop frame rates.
What has gotten into you? I don't understand how simply seeing a gargoyle could elicit such excitement.
How could it not? Malleus is the head of the Gargoyle Studies Club. He'll be delighted to see this.
Sure, he's less at the head of the club, more like the only guy in it.
I must notify him at once. Malleus!
Okay, thank you, Timmy.
Look, it's one of your beloved gargoyles. Please take a look at... Take all the time you want to gaze upon it.
It's a grotesque. Look at his face.
Why do you look displeased? There's something wrong!
It doesn't have a water spout. The only purpose it serves is to adorn the railing. Hence, it's not a gargoyle. It's a mere decoration. Which means it's a grotesque.
Jesus Christ, the bit rates and drop frames are going real high right now.
You must not conflate the two. Pedantic much?
I get Malleus pretty particular, dude. I can relate.
consistently grind my gear when people call the shield and start rogue barrier. Persnicketies, people are so tiresome. The grotesque looks rather dirty though. There's there's straw stuffed in its mouth. What?
There is?
Why, yes, you're right. Is that a bird's nest?
It looks like, wait.
Excuse me, Bert, may we have a look inside? Ah, it's hollow on the inside. The birds built their nest in there. It's hollow. Yes, sir, there seemed to be a passage going from its mouth to the back.
A passage,
Ah, of course. What is it you're staring so intently in the grotesque, I mean?
I must apologize for my earlier rudeness.
You are a gargoyle through and through. I can clearly see the passage goes all the way back. It must serve as your water spout.
Ah, there are so many of you on closer inspection. You each have a distinctive face all of your own.
I know it's a reference, be showing you I saw the movie!
I am curious about your placement. But it's an intriguing thought exercise to guess why you might be there. Are you being relocated? I wonder. What a truly fascinating place Noble College is.
Anyone else have less than a total 180?
Are you happy with them then? Yes, thank you both for drawing my attention to them. You needn't thank us, Leash. I'm sure even the gargoyles are honored to earn your noble recognition.
Hmm? Did that gargoyle just move?
Huh? The gargoyle moved?
Ashengrotter, you must be sorely exhausted from the climb up here. You should take a long rest.
It's just a big rock. It can't move on its own. Are you sure you're not delirious, Azul?
I know what I just saw.
Oh, never mind. I'm well aware how silly it sounds.
Forget I said anything.
I think that covers all the notable geographical points. What were you chatting about over there?
Nothing at all. We're finished now.
Is that so?
Then let us head back down.
Once you put away your things, you're welcome to tour around the city. Seeing is believing, us this day.
Oh yes, it's about time for our field work according to our itinerary.
Bit race, please, for the love of Christ.
Stop! You will find free exploration time so you can learn about city's history once you've learned the tower.
One more thing.
Yes.
We actually have gift for all of our guests as a token of our regard.
Gift, you say? Woo! What you get us?
Well, you got special attire so you can truly enjoy the festival.
Clothes? Not what I expected, but if you're offering, I'm taking. So are they like pricey does or?
You're not supposed to ask how much they how much a present costs.
I wouldn't call them pricey, but I'm sure you'll like them.
All the locals are wearing similar outfits at this time of year.
So it's traditional attire. There are more festival specifically. We thought it would be nice to have all the social participants dressed in these outfits. Or rather, that's what these two thought.
Absolutely. These clothes will help you immerse yourself in our history and give you a true appreciation of Floor City.
A silver cloak. It appeared I found Jade and Floyd long lost.
Hi, silver cloak.
Wait, Jade and Floyd's long left. Wait, me?
I don't know if I should be scared or honored.
Bitrate, get the fuck up!
God damn it, new people are here!
Thank you, Silver Cloak.
And thank you for coming, and I hope you enjoyed your stay, and hope you're enjoying yourself. And also, how are you, and how was your Azul rolls? If you rolled for him, or are you saving for Grimm, or for Malleus, or for iddia? And also, thank you for the compliment for my hair once more. Also, I'm really sorry if there is some scuff. My bitrate just started to die. Let us head down. The sooner you get changed, the better. Yeah, bad timing. It literally just started. Strings. It's so smooth. Till this chapter started. Don't forget, Twills ate their siblings.
What the fuck, Irene?
Anyway, hi, Silver Cloak. Oh my god. I'm seeing the lag, and it's so bad. It's so bad. Also, why am I only at 720p? I should be at 1030p. Okay. The GE will give me his.